Having your SynthEyes senior properly aligned is really important. Today, I'm not only going to show you a really easy way to align your scene with lines, but also how this will help you with aligning difficult shots with few trackings and even stills. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects. Let's get started. When SynthEyes solves a scene, it does not see a street and a horizon and buildings, but just a bunch of trackers in relationship to each other. Depending on the way you solved your scene, SynthEyes might propose a coordinate system for you, but more often than not, you might end up with these rather awkward-looking orientations. So setting up a coordinate system will not only help you find your way around your scene, it'll also drastically reduce the time you will spend putting geometry into its proper place. There are a couple of ways you can do this. Of course, you can align your scene manually, but if you want some help from SynthEyes, there are a couple of options. The autoplace feature, the *3 method, and of course, setting up constraints. And then there is align with lines. In this shot, we've got a lot of lines to work with. Streets, buildings, pedestrian crossings. All these should make our task much simpler. So I already solved the shot and also took care of the lens distortion. The H-pix is fine and there are no major spikes in our error curve. But if we switch to the quad perspective view, we can see that the scene is hanging mid-air, totally tilted. Technically, you could take an unaligned state of this scene to your CG or compositing app, but you would be asking for trouble. That would mean that any piece of geometry you put in there would need to be manually aligned into its position. It's possible, but it would be tedious, time-consuming, and would be a perfect opportunity to mess things up. If we go back to the camera view, we can see that we don't have that many trackers on the ground. We could add some zero-weight trackers and use one of the methods I previously mentioned, but instead, I'm going to head over to the lens room. We can see the lens grid with the distortion applied. But to not get distracted, I'm going to right-click in my viewer and in the contextual menu under View, I'm going to switch off the lens grid. What I want to do next is to add some lines. Right here on frame 348 seems like a good place because we've got a lot more straight lines than at the very beginning of the shot. I'm going to click Add Line and start by drawing a line right here at the lower part of the pedestrian crossing. Immediately when I set down the end of my line, a pop-up will appear and ask me where the line is supposed to be in 3D space. This is clearly the x-axis, so we are going to choose on x-axis. Be mindful of the direction of the arrow. It basically defines in which way SynthEyes will interpret your x-axis. If you want to switch that around, you can do that over here on the left with this arrow button. So let's add another line, this time right here in the middle of the road. Now I will set this one to be on the y-axis. If you are confused now and think that y should be up, don't worry. By default, SynthEyes uses a Z-up coordinate system. If we take a look here at the little widget in each of our viewers in the quad perspective, we can see that X is the horizontal axis, Y is the axis defining the distance, and Z is the axis defining up and down. That is the same system that, for example, Blender, 3D Studio Max, and Unreal are using by default. But if you are using, for example, Maya, Houdini, or Cinema 4D, this will surely feel a little bit awkward to you. Luckily, SynthEyes is really flexible in this regard and lets you change this setting. If you want to set up your coordinate system to Y-up as a default, you can do this here by going to Settings, User Interface, and choosing your preferred coordinate system. But you might have noticed that this didn't change anything in the scene we are currently working on. To change that, you can go to Edit, Scene Settings, and right up here you can change that setting for the current scene. And even while we are jumping through these options, you can see our little widget changing from Z up to Y up. And that is the only thing that will change. What is set up as being up will still be up. Only the actual coordinates that SynthEyes will export will be adjusted accordingly. And this process is non-destructive, so if you find at any point during solving your shot that you need to change this, you can do so. So set this up in a way that works best for you. I will stick with the default settings. Up until now, we've put up two lines. With these two, we've got our origin basically defined at the intersection of those two lines. Now please don't pull up a third line on the z-axis because SynthEyes will not be able to come up with a solution. No matter how hard you try, you will never be able to set this up in a way that all three lines are at the same point intersecting in 3D space. So rather, let's find a good feature like this window frame up here and say parallel to z-axis. But we are not finished yet. Even though these are straight lines, they are not perfectly straight. We are dealing with a lot of old buildings, cobblestones, and other imperfections. So let's help SynthEyes along by putting up a couple of more lines along all three axes. That way, SynthEyes can draw an average between them and come up with a better solution to our coordinate system. By the way, did you notice that SynthEyes color-coded the lines red, green, and blue? That corresponds to our little widget in the quad view. So red stands for the x-axis, green for the y-axis, and blue for the z-axis. If we now hit a line, SynthEyes will use the lines to put our coordinate system into place. We're almost there, but not quite. So by selecting hole, I can bring my scene into its proper position. There's one more neat trick to this way of aligning your scene. If we select one of our on axes, like here at the pedestrian crossing, and switch it from on y-axis to on y-axis with length, we can now define a length for that. Now let's say that this crossing is exactly 3 meters wide. We can tell SynthEyes that this is 3 units wide. SynthEyes is metric agnostic, so a unit can be anything you like. A meter, a mile, a foot, whatever is suitable. The advantage is that now we can also place geometry into our scene and enter a correct scale. So if we place an adult human into our scene and scale him to be 1.8 meters, that should be a suitable scale. But there's more to this. Let's take a look at this example. Now this is just a still, so we can't just run an autosolve on this and call it a day. But if we need to add 3D to this shot, we will need some sort of camera alignment. So let's do exactly the same thing. Let's align our shot with lines. Hitting the ground plane on this exactly will be difficult with all the chairs up in front. But remember that we can always manually adjust the camera at the end. So I'm going to set up a couple of more lines. X and Z are easy, but Y is really hard. Technically, having two directions should be enough. So before we introduce any bad data, let's align this with what we've got. Switching over to the 3D room, we can now see the default camera moved in our scene, even though we didn't track anything. Let's pull up a box and see how well it aligns. I'm going to right-click and switch off solid meshes. That already sits in there really nice. Let's move the camera ever so slightly to put that box firmly onto the ground. Please let us know in the comments what kind of quick tip you would like to see next. If you want to take SynthEyes for a spin yourself, head on over to boriseffects.com and get yourself a free trial. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects. See you in another video.